Someone posts a link on YouTube, a YouTube video link on Facebook. This law, at its extreme, could allow an injunction which would force the ISP to block access to Facebook for Irish users. That'd be a bit like forcing national toll roads to shut down entire stretches of the motorway in order to avoid speeding, and because we say we can't find the people who are speeding. Now, the European Union implemented this approach, the intermediary approach, rather than the perpetrator approach several years ago. However, the European Union has since said this was the wrong approach, and they are actively looking at ways to come up with a new approach. And I have several quotes from very relevant people in this, which I can supply the minister with, but they're accepting that this was not the approach. In terms of it not having the desired effect, the real objective here, I believe, is to stop large-scale providers of pirated material being able to supply this in a free manner, in a readily available manner online. And we all know that there are very negative consequences of that happening. However, the technical experts I've spoken to have said that the providers of this sort of material, like BitTorrents, can get around these court injunctions in about 5 minutes. One expert said it is beyond laughable to suggest that this will do more than amuse the pirates. Ofcom, who's the UK regulator on this, said that for all blocking methods, circumvention by site operators and internet users is technically possible and relatively straightforward. We also know that other countries which have implemented this have seen a temporary dip in piracy traffic, and then we've seen the traffic go right back up again. Thirdly, very quickly, if I could beg your indulgence, Cathaoirleach, there are three unintended consequences. Many of I'll come back to this in the Q&A. Many online companies are afraid that they may have to be shut down. Ireland's reputation as a smart economy could be damaged, and internet access and freedoms in Ireland could be hugely curtailed. Thank you. I'd like to focus on three bits of it in response. The first is around cost. What you've stated repeatedly is that the protections exist in European law. Now, there is a sense that this statutory instrument is somewhat vague, but you have stressed repeatedly that the judges will look to European law. Now, you gave the example of boards.ie. Boards.ie, as you know, employs two people full-time on these takedown notices and takes this stuff very, very seriously. Now, the boards.ie team, their view is this will force legal costs upon them, which will probably force them to shut down. That's their view. It's the biggest online community in Ireland, over 2 million unique Irish users. Their view is this will force them to shut down. Every time they have to go to court, they believe it will cost them about €35,000. They can do that a very, very small number of times, and most of their smaller equivalents in Ireland can't do it at all. So what we've done with the additional clauses in the statutory instrument is bring the European protections into Irish law. So rather than a judge ruling based on Irish law, boards possibly being informed that an injunction had been taken and some of their ISPs were now blocking access to boards, and boards having to go back and spend upwards of €35,000 getting a new ruling citing European law, what we're doing with the clauses in the statutory instrument is bringing that into into the Irish law. And therefore, Minister, by your own logic, nothing has changed in terms of the additional clauses we've added in, but it would give an awful lot of comfort to the people we've spoken to. Just in terms of the vagueness, the Internet Service Providers Association, which is a group including Google and others, it's a very reputable group, they said that the wording of the statutory instrument published is vague and overly broad. It creates further business uncertainty for those running or considering establishing internet services in Ireland. So that's a pretty strong position. That's around the specifics. We accept you're not doing the bidding of big business, though it is interesting to note that the owners of the copyright have stated publicly that they are very happy with this. And the intermediaries have stated publicly that they are deeply unhappy with this. And the biggest Irish online community has stated that this will force them out of business. So in terms of finding that balance, if one side is delighted with it, and the other side is horrified by it, and they're all legitimate people, it suggests, Minister, that the current statutory instrument doesn't have that balance. We have added the additional clauses to try and strike that balance. So I really would encourage you, Minister, to take a look at them and commit to the House before we leave this evening that you will give a detailed response so that we can have time to debate the clauses for the reasons that I have laid out. And if we could have a time frame around that, it would be much appreciated. Thank you.